if we let it. Sorry to say that all congregations don't let it work. You see, they got God programmed out. They got their own man-made tradition. They got their own, amen, man-made commandments. And God is nowhere near. But I'm here to tell you, when the Holy Spirit arrives, when he's here, he will testify of Jesus Christ. When we see Jesus more clearly in our lives, when we see him, when we come into worship, oh yes, enter his court with thanksgiving, enter his court with praise. But this is the day that the Lord has made. Don't you know it's the Holy Spirit that's working? I've been in services where they were jubilant, the Holy Spirit was at work. Amen. Some people are blessed when it's high energy, I call it. When it's jubilant. Amen. When people, amen, are enjoying their salvation and enjoying Jesus, they made a connection. And I've been in the services. And please understand me, saints. You got to be spiritually discerned. Especially if you're up here.
Amen.
And I'm not saying I didn't learn it all, know it all. Because there's some mistakes I've made. But let me tell you something. There are times when the Holy Spirit wants a quiet service. And there's a heavy burden in the church. You can almost feel it. There's a heaviness. And then if somebody, if you're not careful, you'll get up and start blasting people while they ain't bouncing off the wall.
That's right.
What's wrong with y'all?
That's right.
You know, I don't know what you can't do, but I can't praise the Lord. Maybe that's going to come later.
Yes.
Maybe God wants us to pray through. Everybody get on the knees and do the Sabbath test the other Sunday. Everybody kneel down before God because there's a heaven. Some people that fast and pray and spend time with God, you can tell. You don't always have to be the pastor. Amen. You can tell where there's a heavy spirit. You can tell, Sister David, amen, when the saint is trying to divide and scatter. And sometimes there's a time. There's a time, saints, to mourn. There's a time to sit still before the Lord. Oh my God. Sister Green, they don't moan anymore. Oh my God, we're all, amen, a little Pollyanna, you know. Everybody, you know, sometimes I do it myself. There's a time for the marshal that the church has to come together and they have to moan. They have to moan. There's a heavy burden, there's a heaviness. My God, there's a time, amen, praise God. You can say, Holy Spirit, I don't understand what you're trying to do right now. Be torn, turned down. I sense, okay, God, that you want to do something unusual in the service. I sense, God, there's somebody here that needs ministry to. They're about to throw in the towel. They're about to commit whatever. Amen. There's some need that needs to be met. It can be an all-day prayer. Amen. That God wants to break through. We cannot, Brother Marshall, amen, God. We cannot put him in a box. Amen. On the suggested order of service, I appreciate that. But there are times if we're sensitive that God, the Holy Spirit, wants to do something else. He may want to do something a little bit unusual. He may want to do something, amen, that somebody needs. Somebody needs in the congregation. Because the Holy Spirit doesn't do anything, amen, just to be show off and just to be doing things, amen. But the Holy Spirit, when he's at work, he's going to glorify and testify Jesus, amen. He's going to get you hooked up and get you connected in who you are to be and who you need to be with and how long you need to be with, amen. That's the purpose of the Holy Spirit, is to usher us into the presence of Almighty. You see, the Holy Ghost carries all the work of Christ in the world. He empowers the believer to do greater work. He glorifies the resurrected, triumphant Son of God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Do you see the Comforter, the Holy Spirit, communicates Christ to the church? Can you say amen? The Holy Spirit communicates power to the believer. I'm sorry, to the believer. Amen. The work of the Holy Spirit is to reveal the believer the riches and the glory of Christ. The Holy Spirit of the Comforter, it comforts us in tribulations, in trials and tribulation. And in times of sickness, in times of sickness and sorrow, the Holy Spirit, amen, he extends himself to the sorrowing heart and the time of death. You see, his name is a fulfillment of his act and works, the Holy Spirit. Would you stand with me? Oh God.
Thank you, Lord. Thank you.
I thank you, Lord. I thank you, Jesus, that you didn't leave us powerless. You didn't leave us comfortless. But you perform, Lord God, right now the great works of our Lord in a great, even greater measure. And Lord, we need you in our everyday living. Lord, we need you completely. We need your control.
Yes, we do.
That means that we experience a conscious knowledge, acknowledgement that the Holy Spirit is living within us and to us at all times. Lord, I pray that we'll enjoy right now this wonderful experience of the Holy Ghost. Indeed, one must be crucified with Christ to enjoy that. The experience of the Holy Ghost in our everyday lives is a manifestation of our walking in the Spirit and also living in the Spirit. And not only that, Lord, but the most important, it will manifest the fruit of the Spirit from our lives. Love, joy, peace. That's our relationship with God. Long-suffering, faithfulness, gentleness, kindness, self-control. See, all of these are relational, either with the Lord or one another, and some are inspirational. What do you mean, Pastor? Do we just put all of those fruits in the Spirit? We should be working on them, because it's the basics of all of those that are love. Somebody mentioned this morning in Sunday school, it's love. Now, I want to tell you something. When you love the Lord with all your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and love your neighbor, and if you're hungry and you're thirsty, I just want you to join me in lifting those hands right now, right where you are. Hallelujah. Would you just delight yourself right now?